About this group out here called the Commercial Aviation Safety Team, or CAST, saying they're going to become more proactive. This is a private-public partnership, which indeed works on reducing the danger in the air. But here's the thing. He's talking about what they're going to do with that. And this team, by the way, has been in place for 20 years. It was started by Bill Clinton. So his notion that since taking office, he's been very strict on commercial aviation, there's very little evidence to support that, and even less to show that it's produced any substantial results. Erin?
All right, Tom Foreman, thank you very much. Let's go to Jason Miller, former senior communications advisor for the Trump campaign, and Norm Eisen, former Obama White House ethics czar. All right, Jason, coming out here to, you know, ostensibly take credit for no airplane crash deaths in 2017, why would he feel the need to even take credit for that?
Well, Erin, I got to hand it to the president of all the issues that I thought we'd be talking about this evening, at least when I got up this morning. Aviation safety wasn't one of them. But, you know, the fact that we're debating whether or not this is the single safest year that's on record, or if it's tied for being the safest year on record, I think really goes to the fact that President Trump knows how to go and push the issues and get us talking about things that he wants us to be talking about. But I think in all fairness,
when something awful happens in the air, he's credit for that? He's going to take the blame?
But where I would say is he has actually gone and implemented measures on the safety front that do allow him to go and take some credit here, is because one of the important things to point out is that while there have been zero accidents, thank goodness, as there haven't been going back at least as far as the international carrier since 2013 and domestically since 2009, we know that the threats, the security threats, have continued to go up each year. And so for putting in those additional safety measures this past June and making sure that we're looking out for those, I think you really got to hand it to the president and his team. But the one other point that I would make here is going back to the presidential campaign from last year. If when you look at 2015 and 2016, during the primary and the general, the president has been talking about aviation safety and the need to get our airports and the overall aviation system improved. He's been talking about this for the last couple of years as something that will be part of his infrastructure agenda. And so this has been a priority for him. We've seen things get put into place. I'm glad to see that we have a fantastic record. He should be able to take some credit.
All right, Norm, do you buy it?
Erin, thanks for having me back. And Jason, it's a nice try, but come on. It's yet another of the almost 2,000 lies that the president has told in his first year in office. According to PolitiFact, only 16% of what he says is true or mostly true. Extraordinarily, we've never had a president like this with the other 84% that is not true or mostly true. He's taking credit for something that he has nothing to do with. He hasn't implemented his aviation measures. He has plans with the air traffic controllers. They've gone no place. And the question you have to ask yourself is, this is a small one. And you say, okay, who cares? But he lies about the big stuff, too. He claims the tax bill killed Obamacare. That's not true. He claims he's had the most successful record of any president in passing legislation, breaking Truman's record. That's an out-and-out lie. He claims immigrants come here, they're put in a grab bag, and their names are chosen. That's false. He lies about the big things, too. It saddens me as somebody who's worked in the White House and who venerates the presidency. He's like the boy who cried wolf. And Erin, it's going to come back to haunt him because the obstruction of justice charges that Bob Mueller is looking at, it's going to be up to the president to be candid or not. Is Mueller going to believe him or not when he says, believe him or not, when he says, I didn't intend to obstruct? So like the boy who cried wolf, this is going to come back to haunt him.
Jason, to the point that Norm is making, right, in the New York Times interview, right, that the president gave a few days ago, got fact-checked, 24 misleading or false claims in that the length of that interview, which the Washington Post calculates as one every 75 seconds. Okay, who knows exactly whether they were all said at once or over the span of the whole interview, but you get the point. That's the average. They ranged from, you know, exaggerating the number of people who follow him in social media as just one example. Are you concerned about this, Jason? Are you concerned about the stat that Norm just shared, 84% of the time false and misleading, or do you think it just doesn't matter?
Well, Aaron, I do have to push back a bit on the good ambassador here. He didn't actually answer the central question of whether or not this was the safest year on record or if it was tied for being
the central question is the president responsible for it being the safest year on record, Jason?
I think he's had a huge part of it, and I think he absolutely should be able to take some credit for it.
I mean, that's ridiculous. I'm sorry. You can't give the president credit for their plane not crashing.
And you know what? And President Obama should be able to take credit for the years that he had fantastic safety records as well.
Well, thank goodness he didn't, because it's silly.
But no, it's not silly. It's showing that we're having a safe system, and we need to make sure that we are, even with all these additional terror threats and security threats that are out there. I don't think it's silly at all. I think it's a really important issue that we put out there. But going back to your earlier about the fact checkers. I mean, so much there really needs to be who's watching the fact checkers here, because so many of these things are such nitpicks, and so many of them, I really think they have an agenda of trying to get at the president. I think they do more of a disservice than anything else in a lot of cases here.
Norm, you have a chance to respond to that. Is that a bit petty?
Jason, if I ever become a habitual liar and get in trouble, I'll hire you because you're a good soldier. But this is a cancer on the White House and the presidency and the United States. The president should be the most trusted man in the world. When we count on the North Koreans, for example, to take him at his word, and his nose is grown like Pinocchio, he's endangering our national security. These are not close questions. And you have to ask yourself, what kind of man tells these lies when he knows he's going to be caught? And the frequency of them, it's shameful and it's dangerous. So the aviation, taking credit for the aviation record is a small thing. But 2,000 of these, that is not a small thing.
All right.
But you agree, Ambassador, we had a perfect year last year.
That's not the question. We had a perfect year last year.
It's a very valid question.
The president had nothing to do with it. Jason, let's celebrate the fact that the president prevented a giant meteor from striking the planet Earth and sending us into a second ice age. Come on. The man had nothing to do.